celebration of the 11 a.m. Mass for the 13th Sunday of Ordinary Time. A reminder to anyone who may be praying with us from the parking lot, at communion time, a minister will come out to the covered walkway to distribute communion to anyone praying with us from the parking lot. At that time, please come forward to receive communion and kindly return to your vehicle for the remainder of this celebration. For any unable to come forward, once those who are able have done so, then please drive up to the covered walkway, and a minister will bring communion to you while you're in your vehicle. Again, then simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin shortly. Okay, good morning, everyone, and welcome. Let's stand and sing together, "All Are Welcome," as number 317. All you peoples, clap your hands, cry to God with shouts of joy. All are welcome in this place.
together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we come together before our God, we pause, calling to mind the salvation that's been won for us by Christ, calling to mind the times of your sin, as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations in the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come to us in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory.
Reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shechem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God, and since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and a lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. later than Leisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant, Gehazi, answered, "Yes, she has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha called her. When the woman had come and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fathering a baby boy." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Whoever receives you receives me. Whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet, because he is a prophet, will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man, because he is a righteous man, will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward. The Gospel of the Lord. I cannot tell you the number of times that following the alarm going off in the morning, as I attempted to move through my morning routines for a variety of reasons, I created a bit of a mess while making the coffee. You see, without realizing it, I forgot to remove the lid from the water reservoir. And I didn't realize it until after water had flowed off the kitchen counter, down the front of the kitchen cabinets, moving out over the floor, and suddenly, there's Ziggy thinking I had decided to offer her some spectacular treat so early in the morning as she begins lapping up that puddle of water around my feet. I'll come back to this later, but let's address the scriptures first. Now, have you ever noticed how many seemingly contradictions are found in the scriptures? Now, I intentionally use the word seemingly to avoid being struck by lightning. The last shall be first. Lose your life and you will find it. Take the lowest seat in the banquet table if you want the highest. The Son of Man came to serve and not be served. The virgin shall conceive. The older woman, beyond her childbearing years, married to a man even older, will be blessed with a child, and there are probably others. Amazing. Totally amazing how this God of ours works. So, what are we to make of these inspired truths of seemingly contradictions? A woman of influence who simply shows great hospitality to Elisha, the prophet, is told that despite her age and that of her husband's, in a year from their encounter, she will be fondling her own baby son. St. Paul tells the Romans that through baptism into Christ's death, we are buried with him, and then boldly proclaims that if we die with Christ, we shall also live with him. We die in order to live. And then there's Jesus. Jesus, who without hesitation tells those he's speaking to that whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Friends, what are we to make of all this? Well, back to my morning routine of making coffee. Now, if I had been fully awake, I would have taken the lid off the coffee reservoir. I would have poured the water into the reservoir. I would have replaced the lid and then pushed the button and then presto. There you would have it. Coffee being made. No water on the counter, no water falling over the kitchen cabinets or on the floor. And while I'm sure Ziggy might have been disappointed there was nothing to lap up, there would have been no mess to clean up. You see, the reservoir can only accept the water if the lid is off and the reservoir is empty. That's no less true of each of us. There are times when we need to take that lid off of our hearts, of our minds, of our bodies. We need to be willing and accessible, but also have room cross. And our God wants nothing more than to do that, so much more than that, into each and every one of us. And God will do just that. But again, we have to remove the lid. We have to rid ourselves, perhaps, of those things that we hold on to, those things that we're trying to contain, that we're convinced we must contain. God wants nothing more than to pour life and love, and so much more, into each and every one of us. First, we must be open. First, we must be willing and accessible. First, we need to have room. We should be empty, so that God can not only pour life and love into us, but fill us with His life and fill us with His love. With great confidence, let us seek the things we need to help us bear the cross for the sake of Jesus Christ, who promises salvation to those who do so and follow Him.
We pray this morning that the Church, guided by God's Holy Spirit, may continue to be a reconciling presence among Christians of all denominations, so that the baptized may one day be more fully in one faith and love. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations may die to past hatred and rise to walk together in a new life of peace, especially in Ukraine, as well as portions of Africa and the Americas. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who worship with this community of faith may find in us a warm welcome and a place at the table of the Lord, especially any who have been estranged from the Church and are seeking to return to it, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that those who struggle beneath the crosses that they carry, especially our sick and our suffering and our homebound, Baby Philomena Barth, Robert Pryor, Kelly Castle, John Katerina, Bob Christian, Agnes Clark, Mary Duncan, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Mike Firth, Deja Ferdinand, Donna Hedrick, to God in our prayer, sharing those needs that remain in the silence of our hearts and our minds, and those written in our prayer notebook, and those that we've been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pour forth into our hearts, strong and faithful God, the wisdom and daring of your Spirit, that we may take up the cross and follow Christ, willing to lose our lives for his mind was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you can help us for you to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Communion chant, let's sing together, "We Are Many Parts," and it's number 587.